Hey guys, welcome to DSCI Gaming. This is the first video here, and what better way to get started than to talk about the NHL 17 Vision trailer. EA Sports released it earlier today, and we start off here and we see some footage of Eddie Lack doing some mocap. It's pretty interesting the way that they're going about doing this. I don't know if this will carry over into the gameplay, but with the goalies right in this first clip, you can see Eddie Lack pushes from his right to his left and is trying to make a glove save. You'll see his glove close there in anticipation, but then the puck comes five-hole and you see that he actually reads and reacts to the play. So if goalies could not get stuck in animations like they have in past years, I think that'll be definitely a step in the right direction. We also have battling in front of the net, which is back. This I'm really not sure how I feel about. I felt like with good positioning and some of the tuner updates, you could still be a good defenseman and cover cross-crease passes effectively by just being in the right position. But it is interesting to see them bring back this. I know it was a big feature request, and it was something that was already in the game before. Maybe it'll be nerfed a bit, so it won't be as powerful as it was before for the forwards getting tied up by the defenseman. But I know it's definitely something that the fans have requested, and I guess it's good to see that they're listening and that's back. So looking at the goalies here, they're talking about all three zones and how important that is. There's not a ready stance, for when the puck's in the offensive zone, but when you're on defense, it looks like the goalie's going to react differently. And I don't know if this relates to different play styles. If we're going to see, obviously last year they started with the fingers up glove positioning, and we see variations of that now in terms of where the goalie's kind of hinging at the hip and how upright and tall they are. So that might correlate a bit more into the butterfly stand-up and hybrid, which was pretty much indistinguishable from each other in NHL 16. So we might see a bit more variation coming through that. I guess we'll just kind of have to wait and see. But it's interesting to see that there's a lot of variation in the kind of stances that goalies are taking in their net. And these kind of look like they're going to be maybe situational, if not per goalie. Depending on where the puck is, depending on the pressure, the goalie might change his animation or his resting stance based on that. This is something I'm really excited about. It's mainly presentational, but I think it's something that, if it's more than that, it'd be great for people in the EA Sports Hockey League. And it's a new practice rink that they've put up, and hopefully with that comes the drills. In offline practice mode, you got all your rushes and your breakouts and your power plays. So it'd be exciting to see if that can be carried over to EA Sports Hockey League. I play with a bunch of friends. Most of them have never played the game before in real life, so they're not really sure of always where to go or where to be. So it's exciting to see that there might be some potential for them to learn through drills, that we can work together and work on our breakouts or work on our defensive zone coverage with different scenarios. And I guess they couldn't implement it in NHL 16 for EA Sports Hockey League, but it looks like it'll be back for 17, and that's the custom jerseys, custom equipment, and custom logos. And custom I use loosely for the logos, but a bunch of stock non-NHL or non-league logos that people can use. But what's way more exciting about that is it looks like we might be able to have different arenas and customization options here for the first time. And this might carry over to BAGM and kind of the dynasty mode that they kind of alluded to in this trailer as well. It looks like everyone that plays EA Sports Hockey League will have the chance to kind of shape how their home arena looks, which is huge. So it's not just your logo at center ice, but there's things that you put work into customizing. And a bunch of people gave the game crap for this the year before about the upper bowl in arenas not being lit well enough. And let's be honest, guys, an Xbox One and a PS4 is a stripped-down PC. So there's a lot of performance issues, and devs are working to make the game as efficient as they can. I'm excited to see that, they have found ways to make their game run better and take use of their engine better as they get more used to next-gen. Here's a little thing. I think this is Hutt, a Gold Coach trade-in. Not too sure what that is. Haven't seen that in the past. Can't really speculate too much. I don't know. So I guess we'll have to see as it goes forward. I'm sure they'll release more details about that. This is the most exciting part for everyone. The owner personality and the facility ratings. people go back to the dynasty mode we had back in NHL 2004, around that era, where, you know, we could set concession prices, we could set merch prices, and you know, fans will be either happy or upset with the changes we make. They'll be more willing to put up with it if the team's performing well. And owner personality we've seen before, and the kind of patience that they have. In the past, they've said, you know, you have to win 46 games this year. We expect you to make the playoffs. So, you know, there's the three categories. It's nice to see it kind of broken down now into a list. And I'm sure we'll hear more about that as, you know, we get closer to the release and over the course of the summer. One of the interesting things that I found, though, is that we now have a total team budget, whereas before we had just, you know, the salary cap and the amount of players that we had. Now we have it broken down. We have the player salary budget, arena operations budget, promotions budget, and marketing budget. And I'm assuming that we can boost some of those areas by performing well on the ice and by making smart decisions with the facilities and with our ticket prices and stuff like that, which will give us a bigger budget to spend on maybe our players. I'm not entirely sure how that's going to work out, but it'd be cool to kind of see a RPG element come back to be a GM, which has been missing for a long time. Small thing here, semi-pro difficulty. I'm pretty sure we had it at one point in the earlier series and they removed it. That's great. It's great to introduce more people into the community that might be off, but you know, it's a really intimidating control scheme with a skill stick. And for people to come into rookie, it might be a bit too easy for them, and then you know, pro is too tough. So it's nice to have that in-between level for people to kind of get in there so we can grow out the community and grow out the game. This is by far, I think, the most intriguing aspect to the new BAGM mode. With Halifax there, we have market size, you know, the interest in your franchise, and I guess this is for relocation, and it's very exciting to see kind of numbers like this and some of the business play into it with stadium funding interest. I don't think there's going to be an expansion option, but maybe there's the opportunity to move a team. So you take a team like the Arizona Coyotes, maybe they're not doing too well there, and you're a GM or owner in this mode. Maybe you move them to Halifax. Maybe you move them to Hamilton. So that'd be really exciting, and you can see the different types of fan engagement and what markets might be the best opportunity. But you got to look at the engagement, but also at the market size and look at your profit margins. So it's exciting to see kind of a more business aspect. Before, it was just purely salary cap. That's what you base all your decisions on. But it looks like there's going to be a lot more depth to the mode this year, which a lot of fans requested. If you've taken a look at the EA Sports cover vote for NHL 17, that's what they're promoting, this new World Cup of Hockey. It's exciting to see they got the license rights to that. And with that, I think we're going to get all our logos, all our jerseys. People complained about a long time, you know, playing Olympic national games against other teams, and they have those ugly little flag jerseys. And it's exciting that they got licensed to it this year. So I don't think this covers IIHF, but so no World Juniors and no Olympics. Olympics is its own license, but see the World Cup of Hockey there is exciting, and I think a bunch of people will enjoy playing that game mode, enjoy playing with authentic jerseys and authentic logos. We got a cool shot of some hats falling on the ice here. We've seen that before. I don't think that's anything new. Just kind of a sizzle reel kind of shot. And there we have it at the end there with a little Giroux sheathing his sword at the end of the play. So it's cool to see some new animations come in there. It's exciting, guys. It looks like there's going to be some good changes. I don't know how many of those are gameplay changes, particularly at least, you know, on the ice, but off the ice, there seems to be some good gameplay improvements, presentation, and, you know, as the summer keeps rolling out, I'm sure they'll keep on putting out more videos, and I'll keep on putting out more videos, kind of breaking things down. Still a lot of hockey to be played with the playoffs going on, so it's going to be a great summer between looking at what EA's coming out with and what the actual league's doing, and who's going to make it to the finals this year. So very exciting. This is my first video, guys. Thanks for watching, and have a good one.